All right, and we can see some output right here as it performs all those actions. Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. Today we're going to discuss Windows app automation. In my previous episodes, I've discussed automating web applications using WinAppDriver, and I also discussed using Appium to automate mobile tests, to automate mobile applications using Appium. This Windows app automation is also based on Selenium-like UI tools. For example, in this case, it's a WinAppDriver I'm using. This is the command line tool which runs in the background and acts as a Selenium server. Basically, you connect to this server using your favorite IDE. In our example, we will be using Intellij IDE. This is how you basically communicate with this server, and this server actually runs all those actions on your application that you want to test. So today we're going to discuss it in the context of my article I wrote on Medium recently. So this article, you can basically read the description down below to be able to understand how it all works in details. But we're also going to repeat most of those steps, so for you to understand how it all works in real time. First, we need to configure the environment. First, we need to understand what we actually need to install on our machine to run those tests. So in this article, I basically discussed that WinAppDriver is a Selenium-like tool, and basically it means that you can access elements using our favorite way, like driver.findElementByName, and perform click actions or type actions or any kind of actions. So here in this article, there's a section which describes what you need to install your machine to be able to perform those tests. Here I actually have it all downloaded. So what we need to do, well, Appium we don't need to, but you can also use Appium to automate WinApp tests, because Windows Application Driver is basically like standalone tool, but this tool is included in Appium. Basically, you can just use Appium and not have Windows Application Driver installed separately. But for this example, we will need these three things. We were going to be using Windows Application Driver as a standalone tool. So first, you need to install Windows Application Driver. Then you need to install Windows SDK to perform all the actions on your machine. And then as an IDE, we'll be using the Intellij IDE, which I have installed as well. All those three applications I have installed, and it's very easy to install, just a typical, you know, setup application, typical wizard. And also the thing you need to do is you need to go to developer options and enable those developer options. So if you go to settings, and in settings you type developer settings, and here you need to have this basically developer mode should be selected for everything to work. This is all we need to be installed your machine to work. After you installed everything, you need to launch the Windows Application Driver. For me, I basically created this shortcut right here to be able to quickly launch it. This is located in your in this directory, basically program files, Windows Application Driver, and winappdriver.executable file. I'm gonna run it. So once you start it, it starts on this IP address, the localhost, and the port default port is 4723, the same port that is used for Appium and WinAppDriver test. So we have it set up, it's ready to accept all our connections and basically run our tests. Then I've created the new project in Intellij IDE. I basically have it all created, but in this article you can read how to create the project from scratch. It takes a while to load. After we have created the project, what we need to do is write XML pom.xml file, which is basically a Maven configuration file, and we need to add all dependencies for our project. In this case, there are three dependencies. We have Appium, I have test.ng, and have Selenium dependency here. Basically, I have described everything in this article, how to add all those here. You can read this in right here, basically. Yeah, it's main thing that to know that once you start creating your project, you should select Maven right here, and you also need to select the Java version. So in my case, it's 1.8 version, and you can download it from Intellij IDE directly. So basically, Intellij IDE will take care of downloading all the dependencies for Java. And then we are creating new class, and new class is created very easily. Basically, you press the right button, you press new, and you press Java class, create a new class here. And the only class I have here is a Notepad test, all that we need. And here's the all where is all our tests located, basically what we have here. So the first function right here is basically getDate. This function just gets the current date from the system and prints it. It basically returns it as a string. This is the function that we use to put in our test. Basically, we type this in our Notepad. Then we're setting up the capability. capabilities. And the capabilities here, well, we're just using this very similar thing that we use in Appium, for let's say. So we set capability as an app, and then we provide the path to our app. So Notepad is located right here, and we're automating Notepad in our app, right? So then we set platform name, which is Windows, and we set device name, which is Windows PC. Those two lines are not necessary if you use WinAppDriver, like we use in this scenario, but this is very necessary for Appium. So if you have Appium driver running instead of the Windows standalone app driver, then you will need the string there. And then we're creating like new session and using this IP address, the same IP address that we have in WinAppDriver. Then we set timeout to 2 seconds because we need to make sure that application basically started, and we before performing our test, we need to make sure that it all started and that stuff like that. And then we're just using basically annotations here to annotate our test. This is the before class, since it's this is the set of methods we run before running our test, like we set an app environment. So what it does is basically just launches the Notepad. So this set of methods just launches Notepad right here, basically presses it, and that's how it launches. And then clean up method basically here, like after each test, it basically quits the Notepad, and then it starts it from scratch. It basically starts after each test case, it starts from scratch, which is really necessary because this way we make sure that there are no bad states, and each time we start from scratch, which is good. And we have 3 test cases here, and those test cases I have described in my article as well. Very simple ones. Usually open Notepad, press some buttons, and then type something in a Notepad, and then basically close it, and like clear the results and close it. For example, we open the help here, then we press about Notepad, and then we press OK. Very simple. And then what else? We are sending some keys to Notepad here. We just type date to our Notepad, and then we also press the edit button here, and then we press time and date, and it shows time and date, and then it clears it. This is very easy to run. So how to run those tests? We need to press the right button right here, and you need to press run Notepad test, and it's gonna take care of connecting to our WinApp driver and launch all those tests. So it starts initiating our tests. All right, and we can see some output right here, so it performs all those actions. All right, and checks about, and then it runs the second test case. Some test case actually failed. Let's see, this test case actually failed for some reason. An element cannot be located. Let's try it running separately. Probably same timeout is not provided here, that's why it failed. But let's try it running it just separately. If you press this button, it's just gonna run it without other test cases. All right, so separately it works. Most likely some timeout is not provided, that's why it didn't run, but usually it runs fine. The point of this is just to show you how it works in case of Windows automation. And as usual, there is some flakiness involved, so in case some timeout happened and didn't respond properly, then just like this case fails, right? So that's how it happened here. But how do we locate all those elements actually? For that, we actually need another tool, which we got when we installed the Win SDK. Windows SDK includes the tool called Inspect, and I have icon right here, I have right there on the taskbar. It's located in this directory. C program files, Windows kits, 10 bin, and then there is an inspect executable file. What we need to do to inspect basically all the elements? So we start a Notepad right here, then we start this inspect app. What happens now is basically when you press an element, like let's say this one, we know how to locate this element. We can locate this element by class name edit, let's say, and it's clearly visible right here, and that's how we use it in our test. And for example, we open some other menu like about Notepad, and it also shows how to locate this element as well. So we can quickly go through everything here, like all the elements about Notepad dialog, we can just see right here. The good example is this element. If you locate right here, time and date, and there are multiple ways to locate elements. So when I selected time and date, it basically shows the name here, time and date, and the automation ID. So automation ID we can also use in our test. So in this example, the time and date name will not work. So for this reason, I've used the automation ID, which is 26. And this automation ID is called accessibility ID when we talk about WinApp driver tests. So that's what I use. So I use the name locator here. I use accessibility ID locator here, which is 26, because if you try time and date, it will not work. So in some cases, we need to use different locators if something doesn't work properly. And I basically describe it all here. If you scroll down to the bottom, basically it talks about locating elements. There are multiple tools. multiple other tools to locate elements. For example, I describe it here. So Appium, you can attach Appium to your session of the application and inspect elements this way. You can use WinAppDriver UI driver tool, UI recorder tool, and this is the way we use Windows SDK inspect tool, which is like traditionally the tools used for this kind of scenarios. There are also other locators. For example, XPath is the also very popular one, so you can check it out as well. This is how Windows automation works. In this case, we're using the power of Java and the power of IntelliJ IDEA because I think it's really helpful. TestNG is a very powerful tool to annotate all the tests, and that's how it shows all right here, like default suite. It shows the test name, it shows how many seconds it took it to run. Really, really interesting tool to use. Basically, this is how it all works. It's all Selenium UI kind of tools. They are very, very similar. So basically, if you apply the same concept to web automation or mobile automation, it's also gonna work. And I also talk about page object and page factory concept in one of my tutorials. So you can go check it out right here. You can press on this tutorial button and it's gonna show you this tutorial about page object concept. And also, guys, if you like it, you can also subscribe to this software testing break and improve publication I have on Medium. And I publish all kind of interesting tools that I personally use for testing, what I like about testing, just like showing you what I especially like about testing in this profession. Feel free to explore and feel free to join this publication. Thank you for watching and bye bye.